Hi guys, today I will show you how to set up beautiful interior lighting like this using an HDRI map. This tutorial is a free lesson from our new visualization course. Click the first link below to learn more. HDRI stands for High Dynamic Range Image. It's a spherical panorama image which we can load into the environment slot in 3ds Max and use instead of the sun and sky. We can use it as lighting because this type of file has way more information than a JPEG format. In HDRI, the difference between the dark and bright points is huge in comparison to JPEG. Enough theory, let's move to the practice. You can download the basic version of this scene along with the link to the free 2K version of the HDRI from my website, so you can follow along this tutorial. I always start the lighting setup by overriding the materials. This way, nothing will distract me. Let's open render settings, go to the scene tab, and enable material override. I will choose the Corona physical material. We have to exclude windows, otherwise no light would come to the interior. Nice, let's create the glass material for the windows. I open the material editor and use Corona physical material. Then simply choose the glass preset and apply the material to the objects. Great, we're ready to start setting up the lighting. We'll be using an HDRI setup, but I will start with a simple Corona sun and sky setup just to get an idea of what the default lighting will look like. Then I will try to match the HDRI brightness to the default Corona outcome. Click 8 on your keyboard to access the environment and effect window. I will choose the Corona sky as the environment map. Let's see how it looks rendered. Good, we have to add Corona sky as well though. Draw the sun in the viewport. You can see that when I click here, we have the left-hand side view rendered. To fix this issue, let's lock the viewport to the camera view in the settings. Now, if I click here, the camera view is rendering regardless. Next, let's edit the sun's properties. I will make it less intense and increase the size to achieve softer shadows. Remember, larger lights will always give you softer shadows. I will increase the size even more. Also, I will lower the intensity a bit more too. Looking good, I'm happy with this. Let's duplicate the render so we are able to compare it later on. Next, we'll add an HDRI. Open the material editor and add the Corona bitmap to the editor. Here is the map I will be using in this tutorial. It's a map from hdrmaps.com. They were kind enough to provide all the HDRI maps used in the course for our students. Here it is. Open environment window again. Clear the Corona sky and drop out HDRI map there. Remember to use the instance option. You can see it's updated in the interactive render. I will delete the sun as well, so we have only the HDRI map. We have to rotate it to match the sun's direction using the rotation option. I will keep rotating until I see the sun. Here it is. We have to rotate a bit more. 290 degrees seems very similar to what we got before. You can see that the render is way darker than before. We can use the exposure option in the tone mapping to make it brighter. Or we can use the Corona color correct map. We have to add it to an environment map though. Again, remember to use the instance option. Let's use the same exposure value. You can see that we've got basically the same result. This method is better though, because in this case, we'll only affect HDRI's exposure and other lights won't be affected. Whereas if we use exposure in tone mapping, all the lights will be brightened by this value. There are two types of HDRI maps. One is like this with the ground included and the other is edited with black or gray color in the bottom. You can see that if we increase saturation, we have this green tint visible in the image. To fix this, we'll have to edit the HDRI map. Let's open the map in Photoshop. I will add a guide in the center of the image. That's the horizon line. Then I will select the bottom half of the image and fill it with the gray color with 8% brightness. Alt plus backscapes to fill the image with the foreground color. Let's save the image and go back to 3ds Max. The render is updated automatically and you can see that the green tint is gone. I will decrease the saturation to 0.1 as the image was too desaturated before. Next, let me explain the gamma setting. We can make the lighting more or less soft. If we decrease the gamma, the lighting will be less soft. The sun will be way stronger compared to the sky. To see it, we'll have to decrease the exposure as the whole lighting is changing. Here is the extreme scenario, where almost only the sun is visible. Next, let's flip this situation and increase the gamma. Now you can see that we have to increase the exposure to see the effects. You can see that light is super soft and the sun is less intense compared to the sky. In interior images, I like to increase the gamma a bit to achieve softer lighting. I will adjust exposure, value 6 works well in my case. Awesome! The highlight areas are a bit too bright. I will add the highlight compression option to the tone mapping and set it to 2. I like the image to be flatter in the frame buffer, so I have more control in the post-production later. Next, let me show you how to control the lighting even further using global illumination. Here is the basic scene with the object and the box on the right-hand side. The light is coming from the left. By changing the box color, we can influence the color of shadows on the object. The light coming from the left is bouncing from the box to the object. This technique is used in real-life photography by using white or black sheets of cloth or paper. We can use the same logic here. I will create a large box that will imitate the ground. We have to exclude this object from material override. You can see that we have a lot of tint from the object's color in our interior. I will do the same on the wall on the left. We have to exclude this object from material override as well. I will change the color to green so it's more visible. You can see there is a lot of green tint from the box also. Of course, we won't be using colors here. We'll be using shades of gray to have more control over the brightness of the images. Let's create one material for each object. Apply the materials to the objects. I will make it brighter just to show you how it works. Let's duplicate the render to compare it. Now, I will make it darker. Here is the difference. It's a great way to control the images. I will also darken the ground object to make the ceiling darker. I am going to add the image to the background in Photoshop later on. As we've added the background image, we have a problem with the alpha channel. To fix this, let's go to this object material, open advanced settings, and change the alpha mode to always black. Let's add more lights to make it more interesting. I will add the light panel to the kitchen. Let's go to lights and choose corona light. I will change the type to a rectangle and draw the light in the top view. I will adjust the size and position it in the right place. I will adjust the size a bit more. Let's move it up so it sits in the correct place. Here should be fine. I will open the render settings and set up the light mix. This way we can control the lights directly in the corona frame buffer. I will use instance light option. I will stop the interactive render and activate it again so the light mix is included. Let's go to the light mix tab. Here's the corona light we created before. Here is the environment light, so our HDRI map, and here we have a light from the lamp models. It didn't work before because we had the overwritten materials. We have to exclude the lamps from the material override. I select the lamps and open the render settings. Click here to exclude them. And here they are. We have the lights working. I will make it a bit stronger and turn on the kitchen light and the environment. I will actually make it less intense. Now, with all the lights working at the same time, I think it was too much. We'll also make it a bit warmer, so we'll have nice color contrast with the exterior lighting. I will also make the kitchen light warmer for the same reason. I think the kitchen light is also too bright, so I will decrease it to 0.5 as well. I'm very happy with the result. If you want to learn all about 3D architectural visualizations, check out my new interior and exterior course. And if you're on a budget, stay here and learn more from my YouTube videos.